Welcome to the Militant Negro YouTube Network. I am Mr. Militant Negro, and this story I'm about to relate to you is so stupid and wrong that it makes me want to grab somebody and choke them out. There is a woman in Fort Worth, Texas, who called the police because her neighbor, a Caucasian male, choked her 7-year-old son for littering. Now, the Caucasian man said the 7-year-old son, who is a Negro, threw some paper on the ground. He told the boy to pick it up. The boy refused. He thought that was the opportunity he needed to choke this 7-year-old child. And the Negro mother called the cops. Cops got on the scene and arrested the mother, whose name is Jacqueline Craig, and her two daughters. Three people who are Negroes were arrested by a Caucasian cop because they had the nerve, the unmitigated gall, to call law enforcement to report a Caucasian man who is a neighbor choking a 7-year-old boy who was their son and brother. Think about that for a moment. How dare these Negroes call law enforcement because their 7-year-old child was choked by a grown-ass Caucasian man? How dare they? A Fort Worth police officer has been placed on restricted duty status, which means he gets either a fucking desk job sitting on his ass till this is resolved, or he gets a paid vacation where he doesn't even have to come into work while this is resolved. Anyway, a Fort Worth police officer has been placed on restricted duty status after a viral video emerged Wednesday showing this officer arresting a mother who called authorities to report that her 7-year-old son had been assaulted. In a statement posted on Twitter on Thursday, and I'm going to stop right here and say this, if it were not for social media like Facebook and Twitter and Instagram and Snapchat and anything else out there, we would not know jack shit about what goes on in America, in the streets, neighborhoods of America. Anyway, here I'm going to continue. In a statement posted Thursday on Twitter, police said the department's internal affairs unit is investigating the incident, which led to the arrest of the mother, Jacqueline Craig, and her two daughters. According to video of the incident posted on Facebook, thank God above for social media. Craig, who is 46, and her relatives are Negroes, and the officer, who has not been named by police, of course, is a Caucasian. The nearly 6-minute video, which shows the officer pointing his stun gun at teenagers during the controversial arrest, has been shared more than 65,000 times and has had 1 million views. Wow. Check this out. Ms. Craig was charged with resisting arrest, according to jail records obtained by the Star Telegram. Now here's the $64 million motherfucking question. Why would she be arrested, therefore have to resist arrest, when she called the police to report an assault on her 7-year-old son? Why is she being arrested? I don't fucking blame her for resisting arrest. Had it been me, they'd have been burying his motherfucking ass right about now. No shit and joke. That's why I moved from the United Slave States of motherfucking America land, because the cops there are racist assholes, and we the people of color need to rise up and start putting them motherfuckers in the ground. They put their hands on you. You need to defend yourselves, people, because they are not justice. They are not serving and protecting you. They're serving and protecting the KKK and all racist European Caucasians. Okay, back to the story. Bree Hyman, Craig's 19-year-old daughter, was also charged with resisting arrest and interfering with public duty. A second 15-year-old daughter was also arrested, but charging information was not immediately available. So these motherfuckers arrested a 46-year-old mother, a 19-year-old daughter, and a 15-year-old daughter, while this grown-ass Caucasian man, neighbor, is scot-free after putting his hands on a 7-year-old child and choking him. Now you tell me what motherfucking country that's justice. Lee Merritt, an attorney for Jacqueline Craig, told the Star-Telegram that he wants the charges against his clients dropped immediately, calling them completely manufactured. We want to see the officer involved terminated from his position as a peace officer within the Fort Worth, and would also like to see him prosecuted criminally for his behavior, for his felony assault on his clients, Mr. Merritt said. We would like to see the individual who all this started from, the neighbor who assaulted a 7-year-old child, prosecuted as well. On Wednesday morning, Merritt tweeted that he was working to secure the release of both women. By Wednesday afternoon, that release had occurred, according to the lawyer's Twitter feed. It's a damn shame people got to go on Twitter to get shit put out there in the public. Mainstream media is just absent. At a news conference Thursday, Ms. Craig told reporters that she thought she was protecting her child when she called police. I'm going to say this again to people of color. Stay your asses off the phone when you don't call the police, people. Do not call the police, okay? If they're going to arrest this woman for anything, they should have been arresting her for going over there to her neighbor's house and beating his motherfucking ass. Because had that been my 7-year-old child and you put your hands on him, choking him, you best believe you'll have to choke me, because I'm going to be in your face in 5 motherfucking seconds after I find out you choked my child. I'm distraught, she said before breaking into tears. It made me feel less of a parent that I couldn't protect my son when he needed it. Merritt told reporters that video of the incident gets worse by the minute, and I will have a link to the actual cell phone video in the description box of this video. Go check it out for yourselves. I did. There are several videos out there, but the one I'm putting a link to in this description box is the best quality. It shows everything that happens, and the audio is excellent. Back to the story. Instead of being able to protect her own child, she was assaulted. 2 of her children were arrested and terrorized. It sent a signal to the 7-year-old, who was just assaulted by a neighbor, that he could never rely on police officers for protection. And that is the gospel truth. That's what I just said. Don't call the cops. Okay? Some kind of way, work around police officers, because they are not here to serve and protect us. The police statement said investigators worked throughout the night interviewing witnesses and reviewing video evidence, including footage from the officer's body camera. Yeah, we all know that body camera shit goes. The statement asked the public to remain calm Thursday as their investigation into the troubling incident continues. We acknowledge, says the statement, that the initial appearance of the video may raise serious questions. We ask that our investigators are given the time and opportunity to thoroughly examine the incident and to submit their findings. The process may take time, but the integrity of the investigation rests upon the ability of our investigators to document facts and to accurately evaluate the size and scope of what transpired. So in other words, they don't want you to get angry because a cop arrested 3 Negro women for reporting a Caucasian man choked their 7-year-old son and brother. They want you to remain calm. And I'm so sick and tired of that remain calm bullshit. I don't know what to do. We'll shoot you dead in the streets, unarmed, armed, running, standing still, on your knees, whatever. We'll arrest you for walking down the street We'll allow people to walk away free who shoot you and kill you from coming from a convenience store with Skittles and iced tea. We will execute you at will. We will do any and everything we want to do to you people of color, but we would like for you to remain calm and give us a chance to manufacture lies and misinformation that gives us the right to do whatever we do to you that is wrong. That's what we want you to do. Remain calm. Forgive us. Let us do our jobs to prove we're innocent of killing, assaulting, and arresting your loved ones. If you ain't tired of this motherfucking bullshit going on, there is something wrong with you. I don't care what color you are. I don't care what religion you are. I don't care what race you are. And I certainly don't give a fuck what gender you are. If this happens to people of color on a regular basis, you damn well better be motherfucking sure it's going to happen to your ass one day. Because cops know no bounds. They don't have any limitations. Today it's people of color. Tomorrow it's anybody who opposes what they do. The police in America are militarized terrorist thugs. And somebody has to stop them. They will not stop themselves. Happy holidays, y'all. Be safe. Stay well. Namaskar.
Talking about the ghetto. Funky, funky ghetto. Trying to survive, trying to stay alive.
Don't